we can see how his digestive system is, starting with his mouth and going through to his stomach, small and large intestines. So far, so good. We can see his spleen.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little tender?
Yeah, it's a little bit tender.
Okay. So we found one point that's a little tender, and that might be indicating that he has a little imbalance in his spleen. If we come up here, we can see the liver, the gallbladder, kidney, and bladder. We can see how stressed he is at this point.
A little
tender there. We'll see how well he sleeps and his stress level. Is this one tender?
Mm-hmm.
A little bit. The heart seems good. Let's check out the lungs. We're showing a little bit of weakness in the lower part of the lungs. Tiny bit. Let's check out the digestive system. Good. The mouth is good. Esophagus, good. Stomach. Tiny weakness in the stomach. Not too bad. Large intestines. Pretty good. So it's more concentrated in his upper digestive system, where we're seeing a little bit of sensitivity from this. Let's check the spleen point where he had some sensitivity. Yep. That goes right along with his tender point, the liver. A little bit. That goes along with the idea of stress that we were just talking about. Kidney. Seems okay. Bladder, seems okay. Let's check the calm, heat, sleep points. Seems a little bit out of balance.
Okay, beautiful blue eyes. Get a little comments. Just have a little look there and see what we've got. So those are really nice and close together. I'll just check the other eye as well. Nice and still, just looking in the middle of my eyebrows, keeping nice and still there. Okay, do you mind if I just put this up here? Is there something I can see that's not in view? Okay, I'm going to check both eyes at the same time. So, having a look at this right one. Okay. Okay, so we've got a few different markings there. Again, I'm just going to... I'm just going to have a look. I just saw something here that I'm just not 100% on. Sorry. I'm just going to see if they're coming in the other eye as well. So what these spots may indicate, you've got them running just along the inside there. There's only a couple of them. They don't seem to be in both eyes at all.
Okay, so we're going to do nutrition response testing. This is what it looks like. Okay, good. Pinky thumb tip to tip. Great. Body scan. Teeth, tonsils, thyroid, thymus, lungs, heart, spleen, stomach, liver, gallbladder, pancreas, intestines, small intestine, prostate, bladder, kidney, adrenal, kidney, adrenal. Okay. And go in priority mode. What do you have here going on? Okay, that and not that. So we found that the heart is Leo's priority today. Tonsils actually are strong. Okay. I'm going to see what is it that the heart needs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, we already know it's one of the chemicals. Parotid is something that helps with chemicals. 3, 4. That's happy, very happy heart. And very happy heart. This also helps with some chemicals. Let's see if you still want that. 2, 3. No, okay. So we're going to take that off. Okay. And the tonsils are very happy. Great. 1, 2. That's good. That's good. And that's good. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's good. I'm going to dose you. Speed cleanse. One SP cleanse. Two parotid. Okay. Okay. And one cardio plus. You don't need a whole lot.
What, left eye first?
So are they always different, left and right eye?
So different areas of the eyes, in each eye, I mean, like different organs of the body.
Yeah,
so
okay.
In one, in like your left eye, you have different organs come up in your left eye as they do into your right
eye.
Yeah,
okay.
So I'll just use the side light now. Just let me know if that gets too much. Okay, so you're a true blue eye colour.
Wouldn't have thought that.
I'll just have a look at this one as well. Okay. Start with your left eye again. So I'll do your right eye first. Again, just looking at my forehead. Look at your left one as well, and just put some markings down there too.
So now we're going to place the foundation 5. That's step 3. Dark green aventurine savorite. 2 savorites. There's 1 ruby in the onyx. These foundation 5 necklaces relate to the 5 elements as described by Chinese medicine. First, we place the ruby onyx, which corresponds to water, dark green aventurine savorite to wood. Here is rhodonite pink tourmaline, which corresponds to fire. This is agate citrine for earth. And finally, mother of pearl blue chalcedony for metal. In, we clear the intelligence center behind the chakra and then spraying out into the chakra itself. Here comes the breath. Throat. Heart. Circling in. Chakra healer, or could have been the energy clearing. Maybe it was a combination of the two. Okay, here we go, turning. Well, we are also following the vortex. Again, I have that sense of going too fast. So I'm just going to ask her energy field to see if we can slow. We do have that sense of we're connected and engaged. The energies of the gems have engaged with her energy field in a deeper way.
Then we're going to anoint each of the chakras with an aromatherapy oil specially blended for each chakra. Chakra. Starting with the first chakra, so when my pendulum indicates that it's done clearing and gives me a back and forth like that, I know that the chakra is cleared and balanced.